You are listening to chartingwealth.com for Thursday, the 16th of August, 2018. We see stocks down for the day, both the S&P 500 and the NASDAQ 100, and gold down big time, 1.64%. Let's jump first, as we always do, into the S&P 500. What do we see developing so far as we go through Wednesday? So 3 days through this five-day candle, we see that we have a doji with price trying to push through, actually pushing through at this point, the weekly trend line. Derivative oscillators losing energy. Price percent oscillator is heading down just a little bit. So we're seeing a lot of weakening after 5 weeks of up movement. We now are seeing a crossover. It's just the first day of this latest candle, so we don't call it as a crossover yet, but it looks like it's getting close to happening if it's another down day on Thursday. And of course, price movement is trying to push through that two-day trend line. Could be a crossover going down on the two-day chart. Price percent oscillator heading down. Derivative oscillator is also heading down, crossing over, going down, which typically means it's going to keep going if indeed this candle ends up that way. Remember, we don't call a candle until the candle is drawn. And that will happen at the close of the day on Thursday for the latest two-day candle. We look at the four-hour chart. Of course, it rotated over going down back on the morning of Friday the 10th, down on Monday, up on Tuesday, and then down strong on Wednesday, 0.76%. Derivative oscillators losing a little bit of downward momentum in the afternoon. Price percent oscillator heading down, not at the same strong angle it originally started off at the beginning of the day, but still heading down, pushing through not only the two-day trend line at the beginning of the day, but the weekly trend line at the end of the day. Have the markets topped off? Well, we shall wait and see. They sure have gotten weak. So we'll see how things end up as the week draws to a close on Friday. So two more days of movement yet. Don't have a trade. Just waiting to see what's going to happen. Let's go from the weekly on the S&P 500 to the weekly on the NASDAQ 100. NASDAQ 100 down even more, down 1.22%. Now, of course, it's not been up as strongly. We didn't have five candles of up movement in the NASDAQ. It sort of moved up and halted, moved up and halted. And we had an up week over the past week, but what we see happening now is a red spinning top, means indecision tending down. Price percent oscillators heading down, hasn't crossed over yet. Maybe doing that before the week's out. Derivative oscillators been losing upward momentum since it peaked back on the 22nd, Friday the 22nd of July. And again, we've seen that derivative oscillator continuing to lose energy. Price percent oscillator's pretty much just been sort of sliding sideways throughout that course of time. As we go from the weekly to the two-day on the NASDAQ 100, we can see that, of course, it has confirmed its crossover going down even further at this point. Remember, it crossed over, then sort of laminated. Well, it's actually now moving down for sure. Solid red down. Well, again, first day of the latest two-day candle, so we can't call it all the way yet, but it looks like it's packing in a solid down move. Derivative oscillator gaining downward momentum. That price percent oscillator is really spiked over. It'd have to be a lot of up movement on Thursday to change that a great deal, a booming market, but it could happen. So we shall watch and wait and see. What do we see going on the four-hour chart? Well, it's booming down. Derivative oscillator gaining momentum. Price percent oscillator spiking down. So again, don't have a trade in the queues at this point. Again, still confirmed up move on the weekly, confirmed down move on the 2 day. So we're going to see if that down move on the 2 day is enough to bring that weekly over and heading down. Remember, one of our key ways of trading is to have a weekly vertical crossover. Now, don't know that's going to happen this week on either the S&P or the NASDAQ 100, but we shall wait and see and be ready to act when and if it does, because it will at some point, I guess, when. Some point, everything that goes up comes down. What do we see happening on the 20-year bonds? Up for the day, the only thing in our four ETFs up are 20-year bonds, TLT, up 0.58%. we see so far this week looks like a green open box candle's trying to form, but a little weird here because the derivative oscillator is gaining downward momentum as the price percent oscillator is heading up. That's not typically a good sign for continued up movement. But again, we shall wait and we shall see what it shows us is actually happening. So we do have the weekly in a confirmed up move still, since it crossed over going up back on the 25th of May. And what's going on that two-day chart? It's trying to cross over going up. Hasn't happened yet. May, by the close of the candle on Thursday, that derivative oscillator is trying to go over to positive, and the price percent oscillator is trying its darndest to get up and cross over. Three forming, this is really 4.5 days of, or 5.5 days of move. I'm sorry, it's 3.5 candles, which is 5 days of up movement. And at the end of the day on Thursday, we'll see if it's actually 6 days and 3 candles of up movement if we have a crossover going up. We'll just wait and see what's going on that 4-hour chart. Well, as you would expect, it is continuing to move up after sort of sliding sideways for a couple of days. It up in the morning and a little bit up in the afternoon. We see, of course, the derivative oscillator continuing to lose momentum as the price percent oscillator is heading up. So we'll keep our eye on things. Don't have a trade on bonds at this time, but might have one going up in the future. We'll continue to keep our eye on it. Lastly, gold continuing to plummet down 1.64% down. We see that derivative oscillator continuing to gain downward momentum, price percent oscillator spiking over even further down. Biggest candle so far this week that we've seen in quite a while. I mean, a big down candle so far. Lots of down movement. Of course, we go from the weekly to the two-day. What do we see there? Well, spiking down strong. We had seen the chart trying to move over going up on that two-day chart. Derivative oscillator did go positive for the two-day candle ending Friday the 10th, and then flipped right back over on the Monday-Tuesday candle. And so far for Wednesday, we'll see how Thursday wraps up, if things will keep bounding down in gold. Again, told you yesterday we didn't see any support level around that 113.30 mark. And of course, it wasn't. It just rotated back over going down. And then, well, we told you we didn't see much support. I think we found one place back in time where it might have struck before heading up even more. So then we go from the two-day candle that's bounding down to that 4-hour candle. And of course, it struck over heading down back on the 13th. We had a jumping in point in the afternoon on Monday the 13th. And of course, it served you well. Again, Heiken Ashi candlesticks are, as you guys know who've listened to our training, if you're not, you need to. We got a great training on Heiken Ashi, H-E-I-K-E-N-A-S-H-I. About 80, 90,000 people listen to it. It keeps bounding up in the numbers. Please listen to it. It's measured differently than regular candlesticks, so it's not so accurate when I'm trying to give you the jumping in points. Just because of the way it's measured, you'll understand that when you listen to the video. But somewhere around 114, of course, now we've seen a depletion in gold down to about the 111.28 mark. So that's a nice drop in gold. You might say, how do you make money in gold when it goes down? Well, there is an inverse fund. Don't really like it so much. Again, another good training on inverse funds, how to make money when markets crash. That's available at our YouTube channel and our website. Please listen to that. But when you get into inverse funds, you always want to see what the spread is between the bid and the ask. That shows you how liquid it is. The lesser the spread, that means what you can buy it for and sell it for, the more liquid it is. The further apart the spread, the more illiquid or more difficult it is to get in and get out without getting sort of screwed on the price differential. Well, in gold, inverse funds, sort of hard to get in and get out and find an inverse fund that works well. However, gold puts, that is shorting gold with puts, options, and we've done a great training on options that we shared with everybody who purchased our book. Well, it was really a short chart, wasn't it? We've got a training that we're going to be putting out for you in the near future, a little more on options. We talked about them some there, but we're going to teach you a little more about that. In the meantime, you're just supposed to be practicing. We're not a stock calling service. We're an education firm. So how do you practice shorting? You practice the purchase point on a short, and then you note on your trader worksheet what your sell point was, and it should be down. And the better you get at trading in one direction or another, either up or down, if you're shorting the market or if you're going long, the better and better you get at that. The closer and closer you are at, I mean, once you're able to trade day in and day out and you're able to make good virtual dollars, then at some point you make up your own mind as to when you're going to start using real ones. Again, don't fool yourself. My friends, all the best from the whole team here at Charting Wealth World Headquarters.